This is the story of a family and the community they live in. Meet Jack, Deborah, and little Max. And let's not forget Toby. This is where they live, where they work, where they go to school, and where they play. But no matter where they are during the day, if they're outside, they have a constant companion that follows them around everywhere. No, not Toby. He's over that habit now. I'm talking about the sun. So what's the problem with that, you ask? For most people, a sunny day is one of life's simple pleasures. But like any good thing, too much sun can cause problems. For example, unprotected exposure to the sun for any amount of time damages skin cells. That damage builds over time and can lead to skin cancer, the most common form of cancer in Canada. Rates continue to climb, despite the fact that it's one of the most preventable forms of cancer. But add some shade, and ironically, the outlook is much brighter, because shade changes everything. It helps block out the sun's harmful rays, and this helps increase people's enjoyment of the outdoors. Shade also helps lower the overall ambient temperature of where we gather to play, learn, and walk. This helps create a cooler, more comfortable environment. That encourages more time spent outdoors, leading to greater physical activity and better overall health. Shade can also reduce the load requirements on air conditioning systems, helping homes and businesses lower their energy costs. Trees also help enhance the environment by improving air quality, stormwater drainage, and reducing soil erosion. Problem is, we don't often consider shade as part of our infrastructure when we're planning or expanding our communities and public spaces. But together, we can change that by making a formal commitment to managing shade and trees as infrastructure. This means planning and incorporating shade into design, whether you're working on a new site or retrofitting an old one. A shade audit needs to be conducted to see if protection from the sun is located where and when it's most needed. Priority should be given to areas where people gather or move through, such as seating and spectator areas, streetscapes, trails, playgrounds, and parks. It also means planning for shadow casting by placing shade structures or trees to the south and southwest of the area to be shaded. This provides the best coverage between 11 a.m. and 3 p.m. That's when the sun's rays are at their strongest. You also need to consider shade density. The type of tree or structure will determine how much of the sun's rays are blocked. And there's more than one way to create shade. It can be from trees or in the form of built, temporary, or natural shade, or a combination of these. You also need to consider the types of surface materials you use when developing areas. Hard, smooth surfaces such as glass, concrete, and metals reflect more of the sun's rays than soft or coarse materials like grass, mulch, or brick paving. Finally, it's not enough to create shade for now. You need to make a long-term shade plan. This includes maintenance and a budget to sustain the existing shade cover and consideration for future growth. For example, here's what a local park could look like if shade was planned for and considered as part of infrastructure. So let's work together to make shade happen, because we all have a role to play in creating a healthier, happier, and safer community. Check out the Shade Work Group of Waterloo Region's website for more information and resources to help you plan, build, and maintain shade where you live, work, and play. It'll help you make a big difference in your community today and in the future. Just like it's doing for Jack, Deborah, and Max, and Toby too.